السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another Ramadan therapy. We're now in دعاء number 12 from the دعاء of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that we hope can give us healing, closure, love, happiness and be a therapeutic process for our days and our nights in the month of Ramadan and extend beyond it. Now this hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari. It's an authentic hadith and it's narrated from Anas ibn Malik. Now a little bit about Anas ibn Malik. Anas ibn Malik was a young child at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being in al-Madinah. And he was about 8 or 9 years old and his mother, she came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she said, Ya Rasulullah, I want you to take my son Anas and use him as your personal assistant. He can do anything that you ask of him, inshallah, run your errands and so on and so forth. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, in her offering this, what she meant was, I want you to teach him everything. I want him to be around you. I want him to be inside and outside. And because he's young, he was able to enter into places that other people couldn't enter and be with the Prophet in places that other people couldn't. So Anas radiallahu anhu is one of those sahaba who has an encyclopedic knowledge of the Prophet ﷺ's personal details and his personal rituals and habits that other Sahaba may not have seen. Anas ibn Malik, of course, lived to a very long age, walillahi alhamd, 100 years old. He's one of the final Sahaba to return to Allah Azza wa Jal, and he left behind a wealth of information about the Sunnah of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This particular dua, he says, كان أكثر كان أكثر دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان أكثر دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. A dua all of us are aware of, but we want to unpack it and kind of contemplate and reflect upon it. Anas رضي الله عنه, he says, كان أكثر دعاء الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this is the most utilized dua that Anas witnessed. Now that doesn't negate the fact that there may be other Sahaba who use the very same statement and narrate other dua of the Prophet ﷺ. But because Anas was very close to the Prophet ﷺ, had intimate details of the privacy of the Prophet ﷺ and could be with the Prophet in places that others couldn't, it kind of tells you that Anas radiallahu anhu is telling you something that is not just witnessed by him, but would have been common knowledge. Second thing that we take from this hadith is that the Sahaba counted the dua of the Prophet ﷺ. They were like careful, which one did he say more? And therefore Anas in saying this, it's as if he's preferring for you and I to make this one of the regular utilized dua that you and I make in our supplications to Allah. Third, we see that the most made dua of the Prophet ﷺ is a dua from the Qur'an, which therefore sets a very important precedent for us to listen to the statements in the Qur'an where Allah commands the Prophet by saying, قُلْ وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا and invoke me, O Muhammad. Say in your prayers, O my Lord, increase me in knowledge. قُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينِ invoke me, O Muhammad. Say, O my Lord, I ask you to protect me from the impulses set upon me by the shayateen. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ invoke me and say, O Allah, you are the possessor of all of the kingdoms. تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ you give from this kingdom who you will. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ you give honor to whom you will. You take from the kingdom who you will. And you humiliate and bring to humiliation whom you will. So many dua in the Qur'an are phrased with Allah's instruction to the Prophet ﷺ. But this dua, the Prophet ﷺ, is taught it and it's found in Surah Al-Baqarah in verse 201, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that there are from some people, when you say to them, fear your Lord, that they rebel. And then there are others who when they invoke, they say, O our Lord, give us greatness in this dunya and forget the akhirah. وَمَا لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ they have very little to say about the next life. And then he says, but there are the righteous, the best of them, the best of humanity, who say, يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً our Lord, give us something great in this dunya. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً and O Allah, give us equal in greatness in the akhirah. And therefore you see this parity. There's always, whatever you ask for the dunya, don't forget your akhirah. وَلَا تَنْسَى نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا don't forget your nasib in the dunya, your share in the dunya, but make your akhirah a focus. And therefore for every dua you make in the dunya, There must be one of good for the akhirah. For every good thing you ask of the dunya, ask for something good in the akhirah. But then double it and ask for protection from what is found in the akhirah. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. That's the third part of the dua. Oh Allah, save us from the torment of the hellfire. It's a powerful statement. Three important dua. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا. Oh Allah, give us good in this dunya. Notice the Prophet ﷺ doesn't itemize things. And he doesn't itemize things except that Allah wants you to itemize them. Give me good in this life. Give me extra knowledge. So when you refer to the dua of knowledge, which is in Surah Taha, وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. Oh my Lord, increase me in knowledge. You remember the word of the Prophet ﷺ where he says, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. The hadith of Muawiyah and Bukhari. The one whom Allah wishes for him goodness in this world, then they will be given by Allah an understanding of the faith, not just a practice, but an understanding of it. So therefore, when you're asking Allah here, رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا. Oh Allah, give us in this dunya hasana, good things. Remember that involved in that is all of the other dua that you're asking. This is a comprehensive dua. And the Prophet ﷺ would teach us to make comprehensive du'as when it comes to the dunya and then to specify things when it comes to the akhirah. So when he says make du'a for the Jannah, he says don't just ask for Jannah, but ask for al-firdaus al-ula. Ask for the heights of Jannah, the middle part, the highest level of Jannah, which is Jannatul Firdaus. Jama'an Allah wa iyyakum ma'a nabiyyina Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May we be all gathered there with our Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa fil akhirati hasana. Notice the word here that is used is hasana. It's translated as good, but al-hasan is distinguished from al-qabih. Hasan is the opposite of ugliness. It's the opposite of sinfulness. And therefore, when you use the word hasan, it's something that is of a physical beauty. And it's something of a physical relationship. It is something that is tangible. Khayr is more metaphorical. Goodness in its entirety, khayr, it can be anything. And it could be khayr in my heart, khayr in my wealth, khayr in my health. But hasana is something that you want, something tangible. Abdullah ibn Abbas, in interpreting this dua and this verse in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 201, he says that the hasana that is involved and what the Prophet is invoking is to have a good spouse and to have a happy life with your family. Subhanallah. رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً. And if you adjust your family life, may Allah make this so. Make this dua to adjust your family life. Make this niyyah in your heart. Oh Allah, make my wife my happiness in this life. Oh Allah, make my husband my happiness. Oh Allah, complete me with them. Make them the treasure of my life. Oh Allah, I'm not yet married. Oh Allah, send me fi dunya hasana. And that's what Ibn Abdas said. He said, when you make this dua and you're unmarried, you're asking Allah to send you a righteous spouse. So this is one of the secret ways of asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send you goodness in your family, goodness in your home. And if you haven't yet built a house and built a family with others, ask Allah through this dua, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً. And make my family relationships means for my success in the akhirah. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And protect us from the torment of hellfire. Allahumma ameen. I pray that Allah accepts this dua from us. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. وصلي اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. This is your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another Ramadan therapy, a healing for our homes and our private life. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.